Supabase just dropped a brand new feature that allows you to notify your users whenever sensitive information changes, like their password. Today, I want to show you how to set all those notifications up with Resend. You ready? Let's go. All right, we're going to do this in several stages. We're going to start with the easiest, and then I'm going to show you how to write your own custom templates using Resend, and then call those with Supabase Edge functions. Let's start, though, by looking at the basic app. Just a note here that I'm going to be using the Next.js starter kit to get up and running quickly, but obviously use whatever app you currently have, but it's got all the flows that we need. Okay, so next, let's go ahead and create an account, and this should send us a confirmation email. Now, if I look at the email, it comes from Supabase itself. Supabase provides this kind of default solution, but they really want you to bring your own email solution when you go to production. But if I click in here, I can go ahead and log in and authenticate my user. Okay, so auth works as we'd expect, but now I want to enable that new feature that allows it to where when people like reset their password, the user gets an email. So let's do that now. Okay, so under authentication, I want to click on email notifications, and here are the ones that are kind of built in by default. We actually just sent ourselves this confirmation sign up, and here's the new section. What I want to do is make sure that whenever a password is changed, for instance, that I notify the user. Now we can do all these other ones as well, but let's just keep it real simple and just say whenever I change the password, go ahead and send the user an email to let them know. So now let's test the flow by changing the password. Okay, so here I am on the reset password page, and we're gonna change this to, like, I don't know, let's say password 1, and I'll save a new password. Now this will update my password and I'm still logged in. So now let's check to make sure that we've got notified about this change. And here's the email right here. Again, it comes from Supabase, but it tells me my password has been changed. So this is a really great security feature to enable, and that's all it takes. Now, again, once you go to production, you need some kind of email service provider, and let's now connect Resend. We're gonna do it the easy way, and then we're gonna do it the more complex but flexible way. Okay, so first of all, the easy way, I'm gonna come to settings in my Resend dashboard and go to integrations and then just connect to Supabase. Now this is going to ask me for authorization access. So I'll click authorize Resend, and then I simply need to select my project. So I've got the Supabase auth project, I'll select it there. It will then generate an API key for me, and I wanna use the auth.waybackstore.com. So we'll add an API key for that one. And then it will simply configure my SMTP. I could do something like Wayback Store, but other than that, everything is set. I just click configure SMTP configuration and everything works as expected. Now, what this is going to do is connect Supabase and Resend. So anytime you send one of those emails, it will come from your own custom domain instead. Now, I should mention you do have to verify a domain in Resend. If you haven't done that before, you can follow the guide that we have for you, but you just add some DNS records to authorize Resend to send on your behalf, and everything else is handled by the integration. Back in the application, I've created a new user, Chris plus Supabase at resend.com. I'll click sign up, and this should send me a confirmation email. Now, one of the real benefits of using Resend is you actually get full deliverability into each email you send, which means you can see the preview, plain text, HTML, and even get some insights and how you can improve this. So just like that, we've connected up Resend and Supabase. It's just that easy. What I want to do, though, is take it to the next level. What if we could customize templates in a visual editor and then use those templates whenever we're sending our auth emails? That's what we'll do next. Resend has email templates that you can build here either in code or you can do it in this visual editor. So like confirming your account here, I can come into here and make changes visually in an editor. In fact, a designer, a marketer, anyone else can do the same. And when I'm ready, I can go ahead and publish the changes to my template. Now, the cool thing here is I can have variables. So you might notice here I've got this link and it points to confirmation URL. Now, to create a variable, you simply do forward slash like you would do in Notion or something else like that. And you type in variable, and then you can just name your variable. And whatever name you give it, you can give it a type as well, a fallback value if you need it, and then reference it anywhere you want, including inside of links, which is what I've done here. So once I've got a template ready, in fact, I've got templates ready for all these, I can go ahead and slide this to publish it. And it publishes that template and gives me these nice little aliases, confirm account, reset password, and password change notification. So we can use these when sending an email with Resend. So what I need to do is move away from using SMTP to using a custom Edge function to send all my emails, and we can do that with Supabase auth hooks. So in my terminal, I'm going to use the Supabase CLI to create a new function called send auth emails. What that does is create a Supabase folder that has these functions inside of here, and I've got this send auth emails function, and here's kind of the starter code that they give you. All right, let me paste in this code, and I'll make sure to include a link down below so you can inspect it further. But notice we've got a few EMV variables that we need to set up. We'll do that in a second. But all I've done is reference the email templates and this nice little object, confirm account, reset password, and password change notification. Those are the same aliases we just saw in Resend. Now we'll just authenticate the webhook like you would do, and then I'll come down this way, and you'll notice that what we're going to do is pick off the actual confirmation URL that we need. We'll need this both for resetting your password and also for the confirmation URL when you first create your account. Now, just like that, all we have to do is use resend.emails.send. We send it from our sender email, which we'll add in a second, to whatever the user's email is. And then all we have to do is pass along a template. We pass along the ID that we get and then any variables that exist in that template. Now, these templates happen to use these two. You do need to make sure that these are case sensitive to whatever you've added in resend. And then I'll just pass along the user email, pass along the confirmation URL. And just like that, we'll be using our custom templates inside of resend when we send these Supabase auth emails. Of course, we need to do a few more things here. Let's add the EMV variables. Let's publish our function, and then let's set up the auth hook. All right, so first of all, for the EMV variables, let me just come over here. We're gonna add a new file. We'll call this .env. And then as you saw in the code, we need to add three variables, resend API key, sender email, and send email hook secret. So first of all, the sender email, this is the account we're sending from. Remember, we authenticated auth.waybackstore.com and resend, so that's what I wanna use. And then I do need a resend API key for this particular function. So back in resend, let's go to API keys. We should see it's Supabase integration. There it is. Let's create a new one. We're gonna call this Supabase function. It doesn't really matter what you call this. And we'll make sure it has access to the domains it needs and full permission that works. I'm gonna copy this, and obviously you should not share this with anyone, and so I will delete this before you see the video, but it'll look something like this, starting with RE. Now this email secret we don't quite have yet, so I'm just gonna do something like that, and we'll come back and add that in a second. So next we need to push up the EMV variables, and then we'll also publish our function as well. All right, so in my terminal, I'm gonna go ahead and publish the secrets file to Supabase, and then I'll also deploy my function send auth emails. So we've published the function, but now we need to tell Supabase to use it whenever any auth event takes place. So let's set up a Supabase auth hook. Now under authentication, under auth hooks, I want to add a new auth hook, and we'll use the send email hook. Now I want to use the HTTPS, and then we'll paste in the URL of the function that we just got. If you don't know where that's at, you can go into functions and grab that URL from there. Now next we need to generate a secret, and this secret we're going to add back into our ENV variables. The secret allows us to authenticate the webhook as coming from Supabase. I'll click create hook, which enables the hook and uses my function now anytime these auth events take place. The last thing we need to do is update our EMV file with this secret and push that back up to Supabase. So I'll add in that secret that we got, and then I'll republish up the EMV variables. So let's test the flow now and send ourselves an email. All right, let's go into the dashboard just to make it easy. We'll send a confirmation email. This should just use our template now, and it sends it to Chris plus Supabase at resend.com. Now again, I can see this in the resend dashboard, or this time let's just check the email inbox. And you'll see now it's using my template from resend. Now the real benefit here is not just that you can stylize it, but that you can update your templates without changing your code. So normally if you'd write this all in React email or something like that, you'd have to change the code, redeploy the function. Now what you can do is simply update the template that is aliased in your function. What that means is if I jump back into resend and click on my confirm your account email and I change something here, like, I don't know, yay. Thanks for joining the waybackstore.com. And then I publish this. Now this new version will be used every time I confirm my account. And not only that, but I've got full version history as well. So jumping back into the email template, I can come up here and look at the version history right here. And I can go back however far I want to. So I can look at this one and then decide to restore it. And this will revert this, and I can publish it once again to make it the newly used template. Now what that means is your entire team can work together, in fact, in real time if you want to, and change the template together. And when you're ready, click publish, and you'll always know your latest published version is the one that will be used in all of your emails. Well, I hope that was a help to understand how to connect up Supabase and resend, as well as kind of this advanced level of not only notifying your users, but doing it all with custom templates powered by resend. Thanks so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Happy emailing.